In this video, I will explain about user administration. Each client in the SAP system will have separate users. Okay, the T code to administer users is SU01. So type SU01 and hit enter. Just if you want to find out the users already existing in this particular client, you can hit F4 from the keyboard, or you can select, click on this possible options button. This is the possible options button to find out the users. So these are all the users already available in this particular client. So I am going to create another user. The username is user1. Just click on the create push button here from the application toolbar, or you can also use F8 key from your keyboard. Okay, you click on it so that you will be displayed with this screen. In this screen, you need to maintain the address of this particular user. So you need to fill all the compulsory fields. This is the compulsory field, that is required field. So wherever you are seeing this checkbox and it is ticked, okay, you need to put the last name here. Just select user one here, same last name I am selecting, and select Mr. as title, and switch to logon data tab. In the logon data tab, you need to provide the password. Just put any initial password. Anyway, it will ask you to change the password at first logon, and click on profiles. Password must be identical. Okay, yes, click on profiles. Okay, you need to give some profiles to this particular user. Without providing profiles, this particular user cannot do any operation within the system. Okay, just for time being, I am giving full authorization to this particular user, SAP all and SAP new. Complete authorizations are provided to this particular user. That means this user one can do any type of activity within the SAP system. Click save button here so that the new user will be saved. Okay, the user one was saved. So now let us check whether this particular user is working or not. Just log off from here and log back into the SAP system using the related entry in the SAP logon program. And the username is user1, and the password is whatever the password you given while creating user account. So at first logon, it will ask you to change the password. You need to provide the new password. Okay, type the password and repeat the password. So once it is given, it will be logged into the system. So this is logged in as user one. Okay, so user one has full authorization so that it can administer itself. So SU01, from here you can enter user one and click on the change button to change some settings of this particular user. Click on the change button, and from here you can fill the last name as last name and anything else like mobile phone, telephone, mobile phone, fax, and extension. So these are all the fields can be filled out anytime you want. Okay, and go to logon data again. You can change the password here. Okay, and go to profiles. Whatever the profiles we have already provided, those profiles are available here. If you want to assign some roles, you can assign the roles, but you have already provided full authorization. There is no need to specify the roles. So that means this particular user can do anything in this system. Okay, and that's all. So in this way you can change the settings of particular user using change button. Okay, so that is about changing the user information, user parameters. And next button is click on the save button and go back again SU01 and enter the username here and click on the display button. If you click on the display button, you can't do any changes. Whatever is there, you can see. That's all. So it will not allow you to change any settings of this particular user. That is the purpose of display button. And next thing is delete button. If you click on this button, the user account will be deleted. Okay, so I'm not deleting right now, just I'm selecting next button, that is copy. You can copy the user using this button. Click on that to copy the user. Copy the user to user 2. Okay, except address, everything will be copied. The personalization, license data, SAP easy access settings, user parameters, reference user, everything will be copied to the newly created user. Okay, click on the copy button. Okay, you need to provide the password. Okay, this is initial password again. And just click on the save button. So user 2 was saved. So if you click on the change button here, you can see the information about this particular user. Okay, you see the password status is initial password set by administrator. That means the user will be presented with a change password dialog box when he logs in. Okay, and the profiles, these profiles are copied from the user 1 account. Okay, last changed on user 1 who has changed this password. The information is provided here and the date and time and the status is saved. Okay, so you can check the user information using change button. Okay, from here you can change the information about this particular user. And you can delete this particular user using delete button here. Okay, you can click on the delete button to delete the user. In this way you can delete it. Okay, user 2 is deleted. Now if you check about the list of users using possible options button, that is F4. So what all the users will be listed? So user 2 is not there because we have already deleted it. User 1 is newly created user. When we started this experiment, these 3 was there. Now extra user is added to the list. Okay. And what else we can do with this user management, that is user administration T code. So user 1 and click on the lock button here, lock or unlock. So instead of locking user 1, I will lock new another user. Again I will create a user 2 account and I'll show you how to lock the user. Okay, copy and again user 2 and click on the copy button and give the password initial. Okay, click save button. Okay, it is saved. Okay, you can try to log into the system using user 2 also and another screen. Just double click on the entry and put user 2 and the password. Just change the password. Okay, user 2 is already logged in. Okay, now You go to user management screen and click on the lock button here from the application toolbar. So the user is not locked. You can click on this lock button to lock it. Okay, the user 2 is locked. Okay, now if you go to the second session and do some activity, it will work. But if you log off and try to log into the system using user 2 again, so it should not allow you to enter into the system because administrator is locked this particular user. Just you see, user is locked. Please notify the person responsible. So if it is locked again, how to unlock? Just go back to the user 1 screen. So from here you need to enter the user account user 2 and click on the lock button again in the application toolbar, and here locked by system manager there is a button called unlock. Okay, you need to click on that so that the user 2 is unlocked. Okay, now you go to the second screen and try to log into the system using user 2. It should allow. Yes, it is allowed. Okay, for suppose now it is manually locked the user, but if you do some mistake by logging in, okay, if you mistype the password while entering into the system will lock the user automatically. Okay, let us see that experiment. Okay, just log into the system using user 2 and give some password, hit enter. Name or password is incorrect, and another time, second time and third time. So three times it is closed, the screen is closed. Again you can open and retry, and it will allow fourth time also and fifth time also. Okay, five times is over. Now if you type password log on, no longer possible, too many failed attempts, that means the system will allow you to try for five times, not more than five times. This particular setting can be changed using parameters, SAP parameters, that is using a T code RZ10. I will explain you about this particular thing in parameter settings. Okay, so right now this system is automatically locked this particular user. How to unlock again? Go back to user 1 screen. This is the user 1, and put the user 2. You see user 1. We are in user 1 and user 2, and click on the lock button from the application toolbar. Lock due to incorrect logons. The information is given here automatically by the system so that the administrator will understand what exactly is the problem. So the administrator will know that user has typed wrong password for five times, that's why it is locked, so that he can unlock it or he can lock it permanently. Okay, just unlock this user using this unlock button. Click on it so that user 2 is unlocked. Okay, so it is unlocked, but the password is not changed. The same password should be utilized for logging into the system, isn't it? Still, if he don't remember the password, he has to request for the new password, isn't it? So if the user is remembered his password, he can type the correct password to log on to the system. So now I have typed correct password so that it has logged into the system. Okay, so in this way you can lock and unlock users using the lock button in the application toolbar. And last button is the password change password. You can change the password using this button. Even you can change the password from using change button also, but with this you can change the password only, not anything else. Okay, just click on it and change the password to another new password. Okay, so the password was changed. Now if you log off and log into the system using user 2, you need to provide the new password. Just double click on it and enter user 2 and the password is new password. So again the password is changed, that's why it will ask you to change the password at first logon. Okay, so I have to provide another password. If I provide the same password as earlier, it will not accept. Just I am trying that with old password. Just click on the continue transfer. The choose a password that is different from your last 5 passwords. You should not use the password which is used previously. Okay, so it should be very new password. So that is some other thing like this. Now it should accept. So in this way you have to change the password using new password. You should not use old passwords, last 5 old passwords. Okay, so that is the last button in the user administration. So that's all about user administration. Thanks for watching.